The attacks are flying in one of the biggest races in Central Florida this year, the race for Orange County mayor. A new mailer is taking jabs at Teresa Jacobs, and it comes from her opponent, Bill Siegel. West 2 political reporter Greg Fox is here to tell us if the claims are true, Greg.
And this is the flyer, at least part of it. It's actually a four-page flyer, and it tells voters that Teresa Jacobs is a tax-and-spend politician. But the record on her votes while serving on the Orange County Commission tell a very different story.
The Siegel campaign must be hoping this new flyer is the kryptonite needed to battle taxing Teresa, the superhuman government spender.
That's the most bizarre, twisted logic I've ever heard.
Biggest claim in this ad, that Jacobs voted for $1 billion in tax increases.
You can't have it both ways.
Siegel says he put out the flyer because Jacobs has been painting herself as a tax cutter. But Siegel's people are wrong in a number of areas. First, the flyer incorrectly lists 2 years in which Jacobs did not even vote on the county budget. Second, comptroller records show Jacobs voted against a 23% increase in property tax revenues worth $500 million for the 2007 budget year and favored rolling back the tax rate. Third, she voted six other times to keep the tax rate the same, but because property values were rising, property owners paid more taxes each year. Those same records show Siegel voted for residents to pay higher property taxes as well, which he justifies by saying it helped pay for things that benefit residents.
We wanted to fix roads and existing intersections. We wanted to pay our share of bringing the Stanford Burnham Institute here, and we wanted to pay for SunRail.
What concerns me, I think most voters are going to see through this. They're not going to vote against me because of this, but they deserve to know the truth. And every campaign ought to be about telling the truth. If you got something that you don't...
As for other claims in this flyer, it is true that Jacobs went to work for a company that previously received a county contract while she was on the commission, but her job with that company began 5 years after the vote in question and after the contract expired.